Okay guys, this is Smart Tech Info. So today I'm going to teach you guys how you can be able to make turn your AC blender into a DC blender. Now you see, I have bought, over the time I've bought a lot of AC blenders and they never stayed long at all, but I've always wanted to use, apart from using inverter to power my blender, because I don't usually trust electricity power generation around my place. So you see, I've bought a lot of blenders, and these blenders are costing nothing less than around, let's say, 60 to $150. So look at them. As it stands now, you might not be able to get any blender less than around in my own country, Nigeria. I might not be able to get then in Naira, the least you could be able to get is around 18 to 30,000 Naira. So at a point, you see, I have a lot of them here. Look at this one. This one has also spoiled. And me, I'm an engineer. I tried repairing a lot of them. I repaired, but I couldn't do much. So today I'm going to teach you how you can be able to turn your this thing. So what we are using, I tried using this motor. It worked, but it wasn't giving me what I was looking for. I will still get the one that has a higher RPM, the one that has a higher speed. This one is mostly used for DC fans. So then I now said, let me now try brushless motor. So this is a brushless motor. This is what we call ESC. So guys, so you can see the one. So this is the three phases, the three lines for the three phases of the motor. So and this here is the base. So this motor usually come exactly like this, together with, sometimes it might not come with the ESC, electronic speed controller. So most of the time it just comes like this with the propeller. Normally this motor is mostly used for people building drones and aeroplanes, quadcopters and all this thing. But I just wanted to use it for this purpose. So I want to use it as a blender. So if you look at this place now, when you go to market, try to buy something like this. It doesn't cost much. I think it should be around $0.5 or $1, depending where you are buying from. So there are basically 3 to 5 things we need. So we need motor. We need this motor, this brushless motor. Then we need, you know, everything that comes with the motor. Then we need these, will I call it propeller adapter or whatever they call it. So this is what we actually enter here, enter under this place. So you see, this is the part of the blender holding. So don't you see how it has entered? So that when you now put it, you can be able to rewind. So guys, look at this. So this thing, all of these stuffs came with this motor. Yeah. So if you have to use your screws, you have to use your screws and do the needful. So use your screws and tight them all through. So when you are now done, you use another screw to mount them. Or if you don't have screws for this one, you can use nail and nail it to this base. So that's it. So once you are done with this, then this is what we call a servo tester. This is what helps this motor to run. So that's it. So you see what I'm doing. If you don't have screws, you can also get screws, but sometimes using screws might not just work. So you just use your nails. So as I said, you basically need 3 to 5 things. You need your motor, you need your ESC. So that's it. Then you need your servo tester for you to be able to control the motor. So you need it. Then you need your propeller adapter. This will help to turn the this thing that is inside the blender. So once more, I will always advise you, don't throw away your blenders. Don't throw away your blender. So let's see whether what I said. Actually, this I use this to blend this. So I am putting my garlic. Remember, I've already so, but before this, I wanted to show you guys something. See, so you see this place is important. So because of this, don't throw away this thing when your blender spoils. You see this. Yeah, then this. So I've shown you before that you need to mount your motor, so you need to use your 4 screws and screw this into the because this motor turns with the armature turns with the field, something like that. Then I want to now show you how you can now mount this on your motor. So as I said, this part of this motor comes with the motor. It comes with the motor. So what you just need to do is just fix it down. You see what I'm doing? Just fix it down. Let it go down very well. Then you put this. When you put this, you look for something like a washer and put it down like this. So you see, then because this thing is the same size of screw with this, so basically that's it. And that's what I did here. That's exactly what I did here. So that's it. Then remember that you need your power source, your battery. See, this is my battery. Then for this servo motor, I don't know, let this thing come. For this servo motor, if you read what is here, we have a output signal plus and minus. So I'm reading here, output signal. So if you look on this ESC, if you look at this ESC, you will see that we have the black wire, the red wire, and the white wire. So the black wire is the negative, is the minus part. The red wire is the positive, and the white wire is the signal part. So when you turn it, remember I'm using this place, not this place, the place where they wrote where they wrote out, not in. So you now put it. Remember, white is signal, red is plus. So when you do this, it comes on. Then return. So I'm putting this. Then make sure you put a lot of water, a lot of water. Without water, it might not be able to turn effectively. So guys, I'm testing it to see whether if it works. Remember, you need to learn how to throttle the motor effectively so that you don't burn it off. So you throttle small, you wait a bit so that then I said in my next video, I'm going to attach fan here so that I can be able to reduce the overheating part of the motor. The thing is that the real fact is that every motor heats. In fact, the reason why most of these ones burnt off was also because of overheating of the motor. So when you throttle small, you wait. So I want to check whether it has blended. So you see, it's blending it sharp, sharp. So as I have said, this is where how I blended these onions. I'm also going to blend this ginger. And also this. And I'm not using NEPA, I'm just powering it through my DC battery. So guys, this is how to make your own blender. You see guys, it's blending the ginger. Sharp, sharp. Remember, put a lot of water. Then, why I like these servo motors is that it has a place where you can automatically choose manual. So this will just, it can now throttle it automatically. So guys, comment, like, then ask questions. If there is any part of the video that is not very clear to you, just let me know. I will explain effectively or do a better video. So remember to share, comment and like. Subscribe, please.